Hello and welcome back to the channel. So in this lecture we are going to run our first PIG script. So in the previous lecture we have seen what is PIG, why we use it and some basic features of PIG. So in this lecture, as you know, PIG is just like a SQL scripting language which is written in PIG Latin. So for this example, we will be dealing with our ratings.data and the movies.item files which we referred during our previous lectures, where we used those data in the high lectures as well as the MapReduce lectures. So we are going to use those two data files to get the most popular oldest movies from these two data files. So without further ado, let's get into it. So this is our PIG script. So what we're doing is we are creating some relations. So relations, you can say just like a data set, or you can say data frame when we're dealing with PySpark in the previous lectures. So this rating is nothing but the relation which we are creating for loading up the data for ratings.data file. So what we're doing is we are creating a relation, and the load method will be used for loading the data. So we have the data file. So in this case, we are going to save that data file into SDFS. So that's why we have given the SDFS path here. So here in the user MariaDev, we will create a directory named PIG, and we will be putting our ratings.data file in there. And after loading the data, we need to specify the metadata for it. So for that, just give as, and we need to give the columns and the data types for the specified fields. So here we have the user ID, movie ID, rating and rating time, and all of them have the data type as int. So I already know how the data file looks like, as we have seen those during our Hiveand MapReduce sessions. So this is our first relation. So you can just say it as a data set. Then our second relation is metadata. So what we're doing is we are loading the movies.item file. But in this case, the file is delimited by pipe characters. So for that purpose, we have given the PIG storage for specifying the different delimiter for this file. So as you can see, we have given the pipe character here, and we are loading this file, and we are providing the metadata as the movie ID, int, then movie title, char array. So this char array is nothing but string for Apache PIG. Then we have the release date, then video release and IMDb blink. So these are all the fields which are present in our movies.item file. So in this two relation, we have just loaded our data. And after that, we have created another relation which is name lookup. So what it is doing, the for each. So this for each will be used for creating another relation by using the existing one. So here we are using the existing one. So what we're doing is we are creating a name lookup relation by using this metadata, in which we are generating the movie ID, the movie title, and we are creating a new column. So this new column is name is release time. But we are generating this new column by using the release date. So here we had the release date, right? But the release date didn't have the required format to it. Let me show you that. So basically, this is our movies.item file, which I have just uploaded it into our GitHub repository. So here, as you can see, the format has been given as this type. So this has the DD, MMM and YYYY format. But we need the Unix timestamp because we need to do the order by operation on top of this column. So for that purpose, we will be converting this data type to the Unix timestamp. So that's why we have used the two Unix time to convert that release date to the Unix timestamp. And as you can see, we have given the existing format here to identify it and converting it as per our requirement. And we are saving it as a release time. And then we have created another relation called ratings by movie. So what we're doing is we are using the group by function here. So if you're familiar with SQL language, this is pretty much very easy to understand for you. So what we're doing is we are grouping the ratings by the movies ID. So it will group the ratings by movies ID. So here, this may seem like a reducer function if we compare it to the map reduce operation. So it is just grouping the data to get the more narrowed down results for us. Then we have created another relation which is average ratings. So here we need to calculate the average ratings for each movie ID, right? So for that, we are doing again the for each for using the existing ratings by movies relation. So we are creating another relations called average ratings. So we just need the movie ID and the average of rating, and we are generating it as a AVG rating, which is average rating. So here we are calculating the average for each movie ID. So we have further narrowed down the result to get the movie ID and the average rating it got in the whole data set. So we have pretty much boiled down to this now, and then we need to further filter down our data to get the most popular movies. So to get the oldest popular movies, so popular means it is loved by the audience, which means it will be having at least 4 star or above rating. So to do that, we are again using the filter. So it is just like a where condition in SQL. So we are again creating another relation, which is 5 star movies. So it is not again filter it out by the 5 star. It is just naming convention we have given here. So it is just filtering out the average ratings by the ratings which is greater than 4. So I don't think you need more information on this, because it is just pretty much understandable. Till now we have narrowed down our result to a lot more. But if you write it as a MapReduce code, it will be a lot lengthier and time consuming one. But the PIG will give us the capability to process our data more efficiently and in simpler manner. So again, we are creating another relation which is 5 star with data, and we are joining the 2 relations here. So the first one is 5 star movies and the name lookup. So the name lookup is nothing but the fields movie ID, movie title and the release time. And we are joining those on the basis of movie ID, because the movie ID is common in both the files. And at the last, what we are doing is we are creating another relation, and we are just ordering out the data by using the release time, which is present in name lookup. So as you can see, the release time is present in the name lookup. So this release time, we have converted it into Unix timestamp. So this timestamp can be used as an order by. So we can order that by the ascending order. And at the last, this dump operation will show us all the results present in our relation on the console. So this pretty much gives us the oldest 5-star movies from our dataset. So dataset means the ratings.data and movies.item files. So to execute this, first we need to upload these 2 data files into our SDFS path. So our SDFS path is nothing but we need to create a directory named pig in our home directory in maria_dev. Then we need to upload these data files. Then we can go to the pig view and just create this whole script and run it on the Ambari itself. So first thing first, you need to boot up your SDP sandbox. So I have already kept it in a running condition to save your time and to just make sure that every process is running fine. Just go to your favorite browser and go to the localhost 8080 and just log in to the maria_dev, and the password is again maria_dev. Just close these pop-ups, and as you can see, my all services are running fine without any issues. So just make sure that this start all services operation has been successfully ran. So basically what we need to do now is open the PuTTY terminal and upload our required files. So to do that, just open the PuTTY and log in to the maria_dev @localhost as a host name, and the port is 2222. Just open it, and you already know the password, so just give like maria_dev. Yeah, so if you give ls, we have some files present from our previous Spark tutorial. So just if you have those, just remove those files. Yeah, so we don't have any files now. So we can just get our data files by using the wget command. So for that, just type wget https://raw.github/usercontent.com/the username, which is ashaypatel11/our repository name is hadoop/the branch is main/the data file is ratings.data. So look out for the spelling error, just hit enter. Yeah, so the file is successfully downloaded. So it's time to get our another file, which is movies.item. So for that, just use the previous command, and instead of ratings.data, just give like movies.item. Hit enter. Yeah, so our two files has been downloaded. So we hit ls, we have the movies.item and ratings.data. But this is present in our Linux box. We need to upload these files into HDFS. For that, we need to use the copy from local command and copy those files from local to HDFS. But first, we need to create a directory in our home HDFS directory. So we need to create the pig directory. For that, you know the command. So just give hdfs /mkdir, which is make directory, and just give pig. So it will create a pig directory in the home path. So just hit enter, and that's it. Our directory has been created. So now we need to upload these two files from here to the HDFS. For that, just give like hdfs dfs, now give like copy from local. So just look out for the capitalization here. Now our file name. So first file name is movies.item, and our target path is pig/, and the file name, which is again movies.item. That's it. Hit enter. Yeah. So our first file has been uploaded. So it's time for the second one. So just give like hdfs dfs, copy from local, the file name is ratings.data, and again we are putting it into the pig directory, ratings.data. yeah, so both files has been uploaded successfully. So our next action is we just need to log into the Ambari and go to the pig view, and then we can write our pig script. Yeah, so we have already logged in as a maria_dev. And I hope that you all services are running fine without any issues. So all you have to do is just make sure that our files has been uploaded successfully. So just go to the files view first. It will just check the HDFS test. And here you can see, just go to the home. And in home, you can see the pig directory, which we have just created from our PuTTY terminal. And you can see both the files are uploaded already. So movies.item. So if you wanna just see it, just open it. And here you can see our file, which is delimited by the pipe characters. And again, we have the ratings.data file, which again having all the data related to ratings. And now for creating the pig script, all you have to do is just go to the pig view here. So just go to the pig. It will just check some test. And here you can see we have no pig script has been created. So for creating a new script, we just hit the new script here and give the name. So we will give like old but good movies. So you can give any name here, and you can also mention the HDFS location for this script. So you can just manually give that, otherwise it will just automatically create a file for storing your pig script. So here we'll just give it as blank and create it. And here we can just paste our already written pig script and execute it right away. So all you have to do is, I have already uploaded that pig script into the GitHub repository. So here you can see we have the script uploaded here in the Hadoop repository. Again, if you want to just download it, you can just go to this path, which I will be providing in the description below, and you can download this or just copy and paste it in our pig console. So all I will do is, I will just copy the content and go again to the Ambari and paste it over here. So here are the steps which we pretty much discussed earlier. So we are creating the relations by which we are loading our files. So we have already kept these files in the pig directory here. After that, we are changing this release date to the Unix timestamp, and then we'll be grouping the data, and then we will get the average ratings for those. For further narrowed down the data, and we have applied filter to get the average rating, which is greater than 4, which means these movies will be popular. And then we are joining both these relations to get the consolidated results. And at the last, we are sorting out the data by the release time in the ascending order. And we are dumping all this data set into the console, so we'll get the result. So for executing this file, all we have to do is just click on execute. So are you ready? Okay, then just hit execute. So all it's doing in the backend is, it will just convert all this pig script into the MapReduce job. And here you can see it's in running condition. So it will just convert this job into MapReduce. Then the MapReduce job will convert those into the mapper and reducer function to do all these aggregation functions, and then we'll get the result on the console. So it is just running our script on the Hadoop cluster. So as you already know, we are having only one data node here. So we have the one name node and one data node. So it will just take some time. So just bring your coffee and enjoy for a while. And when this is completed, you will get the result as well as logs and the script details as well. So as you can see in the script detail, it is pretty much our script which we just submitted. So here you can see our job is about to complete, and that's it. So we got the result. So here you can see what we're getting is, we're getting the movie ID, the average rating and the name of that movie. And it is just sorted out as per the timestamp of that movie. So here you can see this is pretty much our result here. So you can pretty much do all operations here. So as you can see, these are our results and also the logs. So here you can use these logs. If your job fails, you can just use for debugging to get the root cause of why your job has been failed. So this is the total logs for our peak job. But as I said, this script has been ran out on top of the MapReduce. But we have another option. So that option is nothing but the Tez execution engine. So we have discussed this in the previous lecture as well. So we have the option to execute this pig script on top of the Tez engine, which takes the benefit of the direct acyclic graph, which will optimize and find out the most efficient way to process our data. So what it does is it will just find the correlation between all the operation and generates the plan, which is way more efficient than the mappers and reducer function, in which the process is pretty much linear. So for executing this on top of Tez engine, all you have to do is just enable this option, which is execute on Tez, and then click on execute. So I just recommend you to compare the execution speed of both MapReduce and Tez execution engine so that you will get a clear idea what is the power of direct acyclic graph and why Spark is very popular nowadays, because Spark pretty much uses the DAG to optimize your request and process your data way more efficiently than the MapReduce. So it definitely takes the lesser time than if we compare it to the MapReduce execution. So we also have the last execution here so that we can compare it and see the execution times. Yeah. So our execution is about to complete, and here are the results. So this was pretty quick, and from my observation, I got at least 6 to 7 times of execution speed than the MapReduce. So it really makes a difference if you're dealing with a large data set. You have to remember that you're going to get a better performance if you go for Tez execution engine. So the result will be pretty much the same. So you can just go through the logs to get more clear idea. So I'll just recommend you to practice it more and take some another examples to get familiarity with the pig Latin language and its syntaxes. So I hope you got a clear idea how you can execute pig script from the Ambari, and you can also execute it from the command line itself. So that's the topic of another lecture that we will see in the upcoming tutorials. So I'll just provide this all commands in the description below so that you will save some time and just copy paste this command and get the required files to execute the script. So if you like this lecture, please subscribe to our channel and also ring the notification bell to get the latest updates. And don't forget to follow us on our social media, which I have linked in the description below. Thanks for watching.